Hello, let me show you the basics of Hammer by creating a room that you can spawn in. To start off, we're going to go into Counter-Strike Source, into bin, and find hammer.exe. Sometimes it'll ask you which configuration you want to use. Choose Counter-Strike Source. This is Hammer. It looks complicated, but you'll eventually learn some of it. To create a new map, go to File and click on New. You can also press Ctrl plus N. You'll see four windows: the 3D camera view, top view, front view, and side view. Let's make a floor. Click on the block tool or press Shift plus B, drag somewhere in one of the grid views, modify it a bit by dragging on the white squares, and then press Enter. Let's move the 3D camera by hovering the mouse over the 3D camera view and by pressing Z. In this mode, you can look around and move by using the WASD keys. To exit the 3D camera view, press Z again. You now have a floor, but it looks ugly. Click the texture application tool, Shift A. You'll get a window showing some confusing stuff. Don't worry. All you need to know is that texture scale scales textures and texture shift shifts the textures. Before changing the texture, click on browse and double click on a texture that you like to use. If you need to find a specific type of texture, type what you need in the filter text box. I'll be using this texture. To apply a texture to your block, right click on the face that you want to change. If you want to apply the texture to all the faces of the block, hold shift. I've also placed a wall texture on my floor block to turn it into a wall. To duplicate a block, use the selection tool, Shift S, and hold Shift while dragging the block. With the selection tool, you can also stretch the block, rotate it, and skew it. To change between the transforming modes, click anywhere on the block in the grid view. Something important about all Source Engine games is that the world cannot be exposed to the void. There we go. Now, let's add the spawn points. Click the Entity tool, Shift E, and click somewhere in the 3D camera view. You have a spawn point for the terrorists. This is technically an entity point that has the terrorist spawn point data. Let's add another one. While having the second entity selected with the selection tool, hold Alt plus Enter to go into Properties. Here, we can change the terrorist spawn point into a counter-terrorist spawn point by using the drop-down menu, or by typing in info_player_counterterrorist. You can also turn this entity into a prop, a fire, or a weapon. When you compile the map by pressing this controller button, or by pressing F9, and pressing OK, you'll see that everything is bright. This is wrong. To fix that, let's add one more entity, lift it up, go into properties, and change the entity into a light. Now the map has a light in the center. You now have a playable map. If you also want to see the sky, you can open up the ceiling with a second set of walls and change the textures for those blocks to be skybox textures. Here, let's change the light entity into a light_environment entity. Now the world has a light coming from the sky. Now that you know the basics, you can watch other videos to help you further into map making. Good luck and have fun.